Till yesterday's question, we have studied what are the variables, what are constants, algebraic expressions. Okay, we have not studied till now about the equation. Now we are going to see equation. Expression already we have studied. Expression is the combination of the constants and variables along with the algebraic operations. Operations means addition, subtraction, multiplication, divisions, all these. Now we are going to see equation. What is equation? If the condition it is on the variable, that is called equation. Equation must have equal to sign. Okay, condition should be there on the variable which should have the equal to sign, that is called as the equation. For example, if we have written this much only, that is called as the expression. It will have only one side. But if you are going to write down this is equal to 10, okay, this expression is equal to 10, or this expression is equal to something, another expression, 4 minus x, that is called equation. Now as it is the equation, it will have equal to sign. Because of the equal to sign, it will have two sides. This is called the left hand side and this is called right hand side. Okay, now to find out what value of x it will satisfy, that is called as the solution of the equation. What is the solution of equation? It is the value of the variable for which equation satisfied. Equation satisfy means what? Means left hand side should be equal to right hand side. If we will get left hand side is equal to right hand side, that value of variable we can say it is the solution of that equation. Now in exercise 11.5, a table it is given to you. For that equation is already given, that is 10y is equal to 80. Now out of these two sides, this will be the left hand side and this will be right hand side. Okay, now values, different values are given to us here. What is the left hand side? Left hand side is 10y. What we have to put value? Value we have to put y is equal to 10. So 10y means what? 10 into y. So 10 into 10, instead of y we have to put 10. How much it will be? It is 100. Is it the same given on right hand side? No, it is not given. So it is not equal to right hand side. Okay, so it will be not the solution. It is not a satisfying. Does it satisfy? No, it does not satisfy, because left hand side will not be equal to right hand side. Now other values are also given to us, that is y is equal to 8, y is and different values. So for which value it will get satisfy? For example, here if we are going to put y is equal to 8, then 10 into 8, that will be equal to 80. So that is equal to right hand side. Right hand side may be hame 80 hi diya hai. Okay, so left hand side is coming equal to right hand side, and hence we can say that the equation satisfy, and hence it will be the solution of that equation. Okay, so further you can solve like this. Now here in third question, you can see that it is given equation 5m is equal to 60 and different values are given. Okay, what it means? It means instead of m, we have to put these values and we have to see whether left hand side we will get is equal to right hand side or not. First we have kept, that is m is equal to 10. So 5 into 10, that will be 50. That is not equal to right hand side. Okay, next value we put, that is 5, that is we are getting 25. That is not again equal to right hand side. Next value we put, that is 12, 5, 12 or 60. So we are going to get that is equal to right hand side. So now here left hand side is equal to right hand side, and hence we can say that 12 is the solution of the given equation. Further, one more value is left, that also we will see, and we will find out that it is not equal to right hand side, and hence it will be not the solution. So in third question, you have to solve all other questions like this, which I have solved it here. Okay, so out of all these, only one you will get the solution, because only one variable it is given. Now in fourth question, it is given that this C part I have solved it here. Z divided by 3, that should be equal to 4. It means left hand side is Z by 3 and right hand side is 4. Now different values of the Z are given here, and that we have to put. Z by 3,
value of z is 8, means 8 by 3. So 8 by 3 we can write down in a mixed fraction, that is equal to 2 by 3. Then 9 by 3 that will be equal to 3, 10 by 3 that will be equal to this, 12 by 3 that is equal to 4, and 4 is given the right hand side. Hence we can say that left hand side is equal to right hand side, and hence we will get solution here 12. Okay, so like that you can solve other problems also. For fifth question, some riddles are given to you. Go round a square, count every corner. How many corners square has? Square has 4 corners. Thrice and no more. Okay, we have to make a thrice of it. It means 12 you will get. Plus you have to add something to get 34. So for the fifth question, you will get equation, that is 12 plus x is equal to 34. Second one, each day of the week make an up count from me. How many days in a week? 7 days are there in a week. Up count means something we have to add in that. So we have added x. That gives you 23. Okay. So equation will be 7 plus x, that is equal to 23. I am a special number. Take away from me a 6, a whole cricket team. You will still be able to fix a special number. Let us consider P is here special number. From this special number, 6 is a subtracted, so that you are going to get a cricket team numbers means 11. Now next one, it is given that you will get back me if you are going to subtract me. Something you have to subtract from 22 so that you will get the same number. So that same number we are going to write down the equation as 22 minus x, that is equal to x. And here you have to find out what is the value of x. Okay, these riddles are just for fun. You can do it.